I promised myself I wouldn't talk much before this performance because we don't want to take up too much time talking and we want to hear more music, but it's a genre in which it's very participatory and there's a need to feel connected to the audience, so I'll just say a few token words at the beginning. I want to thank very much Professor Graydon Beeks for inviting me to this collaboration, and thank the Pomona College Band for letting me share the stage with them, and especially thank my collaborators from the band that will be hopefully standing up and joining me in a few minutes. I think the program explains all I want to say about these songs. Are we tuning? Oh, we're tuning after I sing. You guys don't want to stand? Please. These are my collaborators. Thank you very much. But just in brief, this is a chance to look at a composer's arrangement of vernacular music and song material and put that side by side with a realistic or naturalistic interpretation of the genre from which that music comes. So I wish I had put this in the performance before, or rather on the program, but since then I've decided to change the title of this segment, whereas the piece that the band will play just after our sung performance is called The Fantasy on American Sailing Songs. I'm going to call this one The Reality on American Sailing Songs. Okay, I think I feel warm enough and connected to you guys that the performance. You demos attend, and you Federalists too, I'll sing you a song that you all know is true. Concerning the Hornet, true stuff, I'll be bail, that rumpled the peacock and lowered his tail. Sing hover, oh hover, cries old granny whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our navy, cries old granny whale. This bird, she was bred in the land of King George. Her feathers were fine and her tail very large. She spread forth her wings like a ship in full sail and prided herself on the size of her tail. Sing hover, oh bubber, cries old granny whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our navy, cries old granny whale. Oh, King George, he then says, to America go. The hornet and wasp are the British king's foe. Pick them up, my dear bird, spread your wings to the gale, but beware of those insects, cries old granny whale. Sing hover, oh bubber, cries old granny whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our navy, cries old granny whale. So away flew that bird at the word of command. Her flight was directed to freedom's own land. The hornet discovered her wings on the sail and quickly determined to tickle her tail. Sing hover, oh bubber, cries old granny whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our navy, cries old granny whale. So they then had it out. It was both pick and sting. The hornet still working keen under her wing. American insects, quoth she, I'll be bail. We'll humble the kingbird and lower her tail. Sing hover, oh bubber, cries old granny whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our navy, cries old granny whale. Now the peacock, now mortally under her wing, did feel the full force of the hornet's sharp sting. She flattened her crest like a shoal on the whale, sunk down on her side, and lowered her tail. sing, hover above her, cries old Granny Whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success
to our Navy, cries old Granny.
Oh, success, the brave Lawrence, who well knew the nest where the hornet and wasp in their honor still rest. We'll send them a force, and with strength I'll be bail. We'll humble King George and lower his keel. Sing, hover, bummer, cries old Granny Whale. The hornet can tickle the British bird's tail. Her stings are all sharp and they'll pierce without fail. Success to our Navy, cries old Granny Whale.
That was a broadside ballad from 1813. Topical commentary on events that had just happened during the War of 1812. Now we're moving on to three work songs. The very first work song can be dated to the 1820s. I would bet most of the people in the audience have heard this song before in some fashion. It actually went out of fashion in terms of being sung on sailing ships shortly after that decade, but it was revived by people like ourselves singing and for entertainment purposes on the shore. So you'll recognize this, and with all the rest of the final three songs, I encourage anyone who would like to sing along, please. And that goes for the band too, the whole thing. Took for that particular one. So it's the reality on American Sailing Songs, right? Now, for our last two, these are shanties. These date from the 1860s. The first one is called Lowlands.
My dollar and a half a day.
Oh, was you ever in Mobile Bay?
Lowlands, lowlands away,
miles down. Oh, screw and cotton all the day.
My dollar and a half a day.
And was you ever in New York town?
Lowlands, lowlands away, my
God. For a stroll in Broadway, up and down,
my dollar and a half a day.
And was you ever in Rio? Down gold sands,
my dollar and a half a day.
Thank you. Some lyrics to sing. Oh, say was you ever down Rio Grande? Oh, Rio, it's there where the river flows down golden sands,
and we're bound for Rio Grande.
Is no place for me.
Away,
so I'll pack up my bags and I'll go off to sea,
and we're bound for Rio Grande, and away to Rio. Away.
$2 a day, his sail is pay.
Away, Rio.
So let's pack up your donkey and get underway,
and we're bound for Rio Grande, and away.
Salt cod
mighty anger.